So, you couldn't get enough Tanis. Let's go. As the years have gone on, Tanis has collected a veritable museum of fabled treasures, art, magic items, even a creature or two that bears some unique trait. Yet, in his personal collection, he still keeps a glass case with a velvet pillow, waiting for the day when he once again crosses paths with that glimmering gem from his youth that has started his journey. The cool thing about Memorable Monsters and Tanis here is that not only do we give you a great backstory, but we give you current motives, a variety of ways to use the creature, as well as flaws and, of course, a stat block. Let's take a look. Tanis Caro is always on the lookout for valuable treasures as his current motive, holding rarity and history above all else. He does most of his regular business through representatives to keep his identity and location obscured, but if someone offers a relic that piques his interest enough, he might just arrange a face-to-face meeting. As you can see below that, Memorable Monsters gives a collection of different ways that you can actually use Tanis as an information giver. His home is a museum of rare and valuable relics, and he knows the history of each and every one. If there is hidden knowledge known only by a few, Tanis probably knows it. As a quest giver, though unscrupulous in most of his practices, Tanis is always on the lookout for the more curiosities to add to his collection. If it is rare, he's looking to hire someone to procure it for him. Of course, he can be a merchant. Even the rarest items of Tanis' collection can be bought, though the price may include more than just gold. And of course, he can be used as a villain. If Tanis Caro wants something to add to his collection, he's going to get it. If a group of adventurers finds an ancient relic in a dragon's hoard that they aren't selling, they might just find themselves in trouble the next time they make camp. What would a good NPC be without long-term motives and flaws? Though he has long outlived most of his blood relatives, Tanis knows better than anyone that life is fleeting and that time is the ultimate enemy. He has not revealed this to anybody, but his eventual goal is to find a way to escape death, and no method of extending his life, from becoming a lich to transforming his soul into another person's body to create a magical vessel to hold his consciousness, is beyond his moral horizon. Of course, when it comes to flaws, a lifetime of dealing with underlings and servants has left him feeling a bit superior and giving him a serious superiority complex. He believes he can manipulate anybody, and so he's willing to try. While Tanis has some really cool abilities in this Memorable Monsters, my favorite is